Another day of deal.
We're making progress.
Well, we're taking our time to go through all the details. We're getting close.
Or no deal, different day, same hotel.
Hang on, I'm in the middle of a conference here.
Hey. Caffeine ready as the coalition carrot dangling continues.
We're going to carry on our conversations today. We made great progress yesterday. We hope to do the same again today.
Well, the answer's not with me, it's with others as well.
But 2.5 hours later...
Mr. Peters, are you feeling good?
Yes, I am. How about you?
No closer, though, to voters knowing what's on and off the table.
Again, not getting into conversations that we're having in the room. Again, I'm not getting into any of those details. Again, not getting into any of that.
Neither is Mr. Peters.
No.
With talks not coming back here for now.
When we're ready, we'll come to Wellington. But I imagine we're going to be in Auckland over the weekend.
It's 34 days since the election, 14 since special votes came back, 2 since the recounts. As talks drag on, Christopher Luxon's big business background's being put to the test.
I've done a lot, obviously, in my business life at Unilever and also at Air New Zealand. But
What were the examples?
I'm not going into them specifically.
No specifics either yet on who could get what.
Have you discussed you being Deputy Prime Minister?
Look, we've discussed a whole lot of options around that. It's being discussed amongst what does the government look like and all sorts of options. So,
Winston Peters says you haven't discussed ministerial portfolios, but
correct.
You have with ACT. It's more advanced?
Just in very loose terms, with what? ACT.
Will you be foreign minister then?
Wheeling and dealing goes on another day. Kim Baker-Wilson, One News.
Political editor Jessica Mutch-McKay joins us now live. Jess, any more intel or insights on when we'll get a deal?
Sources are telling me that there is a slim to low chance we will get a deal tomorrow. New Zealand First and National still have a few more hours of negotiations, and that is set to take place tomorrow in Auckland and could also drag into Sunday as well. They are making progress, as we heard over and over again today, and I'm told that the number of issues is narrowing, but they haven't yet got onto that issue of ministerial portfolios, which is that final stage. ACT is further along in the process. In fact, today, ACT and National were just emailing back and forth, arguing about wording. They have covered the issue of ministerial portfolios. But of course, it's three parties in all of this. It is a coalition triangle. ACT and New Zealand First have just wrapped up a meeting about 20 minutes ago.
This triangle, give us an idea of how much pressure is on the politicians to get it done.
It has been 5 long weeks since the election, or at least it's felt like it here, and it's now the longest coalition talks this century. The last time it was longer was in 1996. It was 8 weeks of coalition talks, but that was when MMP was just brand new. And even if you compare it to 2017, when New Zealand First and Winston Peters was choosing between 2 parties, it only took 4 weeks. All of the parties are stressing they want to get it right, but there really is pressure growing, especially on the man at the top, to get MPs back in this place as quickly as they can. This is his first real test as Prime Minister, and it's taking him a long time to execute.
Tēnā koe, Jess, at Parliament, Jessica Mutch-McKay.